for the man to speak to about visions, outbreaks of hysteria. I'm trying to get to the bottom of it myself.
Another newcomer with another problem. Yes, I know what you speak of.
Can I ask you a few questions?
How dare you? My son Albert is missing, and no one in this Innsmouth-ridden city will do a damn thing. But yes, let's talk about your dreams.
I take it you're not the biggest fan of these Innsmouthers.
Those fish-faced freaks have overrun this city since the police burned Innsmouth to the ground. But now, those filthy migrants occupy half this damn city. The port, Grimhaven Bay, Salvation Harbor, the Shells, they are everywhere.
So they're just refugees?
Hardly. They've taken work from the local fishermen. They stir and agitate against us, the Throgmorton family. We are the pillar of this community, not to mention that crime rates have skyrocketed. Simply speaking, they are a big stinking pile of trouble.
Mr. Throgmorton, let me help you. I'm rather good at tracking down missing people. I'll find Albert.
What makes you think you can do it? Oakmont is not exactly friendly to new arrivals.
Let's just say I tend to see things that others miss. And anyway, what have you got to lose? Sounds like you could use every man you can get.
Vera, you have a point, newcomer.
Please forgive the question, but I've never met a man quite like you before.
That's because no man measures up to the Throgmorton lineage. Proud and powerful blood flows through our veins. My father united with a certain royal family, which has blessed all our offspring with these exquisite features.
Sorry, did you just say Vera? What does that mean?
You had better get used to the Oakmont dialect, outsider. That is, if you want to fit in. It is a fascinating blend.
As much as I'm enjoying the weather, Mr. Throgmorton, it's time for me to get started.
Find my son, newcomer, and be quick about it.
It would take tremendous effort to move this thing, let alone tossing it over like this.
Let's see what you find, newcomer.
Hello? Hey, can you hear me?
Oh, my head. What? Who are you? Are you police? I've already told them everything.
It's okay. I'm Charles Reed, Private Eye. Mr. Throgmorton hired me to find his son.
Okay. What do you want?
I want to know what happened here. Every detail.
I don't remember much. Me, Paul, and Lewis. We were here. This is our house. Barry was outside, on his business. Then he came back carrying Throgmorton's son. He was unconscious. Barely breathing. Barry left again to call Mr. Robert.
Then what?
We put the guy in Lewis's room. Then he started to make these horrible sounds and... Okay. My head began to burst. And he woke up. And after that, I don't remember a thing. Just dreams. Drowned streets, a sleeping giant, a voice that called me...
That sounds familiar.
Detective... Sir, tell me the truth. Could it be me? Did I kill Paul? Or... Kane? Did I kill him?
I don't know yet, Will. The police will stop anyone coming in or out of here, so I suggest you just try and get some rest.
I'm afraid of what I might dream.
I can barely recognize the face of the poor fella. He was beaten to a pulp. Choo-choo. Ahem. Five cards short of a full house. I'm surprised they don't have someone's portrait here. Never seen knives like this before. Masterful work. Seems like Prohibition hasn't affected Oakmont too much. So, that's what an Innsmouther looks like. Where's your Oberon, huh, Titania?
I still hear those voices.
Thank you. Run!
Take this, ape face.
What's happening?
Okay, let's see what we have here.
What's happening?
Take this, ape face.
Yeah, run!
When Albert Throgmorton woke up, he was not himself. He attacked the fishermen and his hysteria spread to them. When he got wounded, he fled. So the fisherman pursued Albert, even let off a few shots.
The port is closed by order of Robert Throgmorton. Back off.
Stay alert. Monsters lurk underground. They're everywhere.
Welcome to Under the Keel. What are you? You want a drink?
Ugh, I'll miss the Carpenter's food giveaway with this darn port closure.
something in the pocket. And the blood is fresh. Whomever it belongs to could not have gotten far. Fatal round through the forehead. That's no accident. This was deliberate. Fatal round through the forehead. That's no accident. This was deliberate. I've seen some unsettling creatures around, like nothing I've ever encountered. What are they?
So you met a wild beast, newcomer. No one knows what they are, but consider yourself lucky to still be in one piece. They arrived in the Flood. Some say they come from the sea. Others that they are Kay's punishment for us.
And what do you say?
If it bleeds, you can kill it. Keep your gun handy. And if you want to erase the memory, I sell a perfect cure right here. Remember, better to be a coward and live than brave and dead. Unless you're a newcomer.
I'm looking for a man by the name of Lewis Flynn. Any chance he's here?
Yeah. Even if I knew, I don't rat to newcomers.
As it happens, I know you owe a debt to Mr. Flynn. Trouble is, I found your note near the dead body of Albert Throgmorton, son of Robert. So, it seems Lewis is in trouble. Might have even come here to hide. But you hand him over, and he won't be back to collect what you owe. Get me?
Throck. That would explain the blood. Fine. If it gets me out of this mess, you can have him.
So?
He's upstairs. Here's the key. You gotta promise to deal with him once and for all. But save the shooting for outside, huh?
Smart man. There's your good deed for the day. Bye.
Hey, who are you? What are you doing?
Charles Reed, private investigator. Mr. Throgmorton hired me to find his son Albert, so I think you know why I'm here.
Throg. That darn bartender. It was all that crazy ape's fault. You hear me?
Calm down. I only want to speak, for now. But no, if you reach for your gun, you'll hit the floor faster than you can say poetic justice.
I got nothing to hide.
Start at the beginning.
Please, I told you the truth, I swear.
Mr. Throgmorton, I'm afraid I have...